रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम रिस्पेक्टिव व्यूअर्स, लेडीज़ एंड जेंटलमैन, वेलकम टू द प्रोग्राम 114 डायलॉग्स विद कुरान। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सूरतुल अहकाफ। अहकाफ मीन्स अ माउंटेन एंड हम्प ऑफ अ सेंट। दिस वर्ड हैज़ बीन टेकन फ्रॉम वन ऑफ द वर्स of the surah wadhkur akha ad iz anzara qawmahu bil ahqab, mention the name of ad's brother who was hazrat hud alayhi salam, who addressed and warned to his people when he was standing on a mountain and hump of a saint. This surah has highlighted the tragic end of nation of Ad, who were strong, they would presume themselves very aristocratic and powerful, but when they rejected the faith and they tormented their prophet, as a consequence and result they were entangled in displeasure and torment of Allah Almighty. This surah has also warned to all the enemies of Islam, the Quraysh and all other non-believers of Hazrat Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's time, that if they did not mend their ways and change their course of life, they will also meet very tragic end. This is Makki surah and it comprises 4 rukus and 35 verses. The main topics of the surah, first of all, the real Lord of the universe. It has been highlighted in the surah that Allah Almighty is the creator of this universe. He is Lord. This universe is not unattended. Ultimate authority and sovereign power of Allah Almighty has created it, and He manages all the matters systematically. And this is a purposeful life. It is not aimless or useless. Second important topic is severe warning to the non-believers. It has been addressed to all the enemies of Islam, especially the Quraysh, who were not ready to embrace Islam and accept the message of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They were warned that the previous and old ancient nations who rejected the faith and who did not acknowledge the reality of the messengers of Allah Almighty, they were totally ruined and they went to dogs. So they must learn a lesson from the history of old nations. Another topic is the rights of the parents. This surah has highlighted that our parents deserve our love, our affection and humble services. Especially the mother deserves the most of all. So this surah is very important in this regard, that our parents must be entertained and served with humble attention and complete devotion. Another topic in this surah, it has also been pointed out that a group of jinns, they came to Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and they embraced Islam and they promised Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that they would go to their nation and they would also preach the teachings of Islam. And it was also clarified that the tragic end is the ultimate result of all the rejectors. Another topic is the bad consequences and results of rejectors of the doomsday, because this was misconception of the non-believers that there would be no doomsday or the day of judgment. It was clarified that Allah Almighty will give new birth to all human beings. They would be accumulated and gathered and collected, and they all will be held answerable. Allah Almighty has a power to give life to all human beings once, and He can also give life for the twice and second time, and He does not need any special attention. He only says kun, it is to be done and it will be done. وَإِذَا قَضَىٰ أَمْرًا فَإِنَّمَا يُقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ. When He decides to do anything, He only says, let it be done, and it is done. The last topic is advice to Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He has been advised to be steadfast in his mission and to be patient against the intrigues and conspiracy and machinations of the non-believers, because this was the habit of the rejectors of the non-believers to oppose their prophets. As it is said, a prophet is seldom honored in his own time. But mind this point, that the ultimate success and victory is only for the righteous one. Thanks so nice of you. Assalamu alaikum, respected viewers, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the program 114 Dialogues with Quran. Today we are going to discuss Surah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Muhammad means the most honored, respected, admired, and praised fellow, the servant of Allah Almighty, the messenger of Allah Almighty. This is the name of the last prophet and messenger of Allah Almighty. And this word has been derived from the verse وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَآمَنُوا بِمَا نُزِّلَ عَلَىٰ مُحَمَّدٍ. And the people who believed in and they did the righteous jobs and actions, and they also believed in whatever was revealed and sent to Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was utilized in this verse. The main theme of this surah is to encourage the Muslims, the believers, and to reinforce their courage, because courage and initiative is necessary to achieve any goal and target of life. The people who are steadfast, courageous, and they put their belief on Allah Almighty and His assistance and help and favors, they are never failed. This is Madani Surah, and it comprises 4 rukus and 38 verses. In the very opening verses of this Surah, it was clarified that the torch of Islam and the light of faith will spread all over the world. All the believers have been patronized by Allah Almighty. They have been encouraged that they should never lose heart. They must be steadfast in their mission, because Allah Almighty has decided to dominate Islam, and it will spread with the favor of Allah Almighty, and the Muslims must get ready to achieve all the targets and goals of Islam with complete help of Allah Almighty. Allah Almighty will also send angels, and His help will reach at every time. Among other important topics, for the first time the Muslims were allowed to fight against the enemies. They were given and granted permission for crusade, for a holy war, and it was also highlighted that if the Muslims are killed, they would be called martyrs, and Allah Almighty will honor them, will grant them, provide them with paradise, with heavens and great status, and all of their sins will be forgiven who sacrificed their dear lives for the cause of Islam. Another topic, that is patronage of Allah Almighty and His help. The Muslims have been advised, never be afraid of the devil and the Satan and the followers of Satan and devil and enemies of Islam, because in spite of their great resources and material weapons and ammunition, they will go to dogs, they will lick the dust, because Allah Almighty has decided to spread the light of Islam by all means. There is also another topic of the hypocrites. It has been discussed that the hypocrites would claim that if there would be crusade, they would be allowed to fight against enemies of Islam. They would prove their courage, bravery, steadfastness. But when the commandment for holy war was sanctioned by Allah Almighty, they became timid and cowardice encircled them. Otherwise, they would boast of their courage and their great objectives. So this surah has also highlighted the group of the hypocrites. Then there are also special instructions to the freedom fighters. All the Muslims have been ordered and advised never to bow before the enemies, and they must put their strong faith on Allah Almighty. They never make any application request for compromise. The enemies must lick the dust, and the message of Islam must spread all over the world. They must put their strong faith and trust on Allah Almighty. The last topic of this surah, all the Muslims were advised to spend their wealth to do holy war with their materials, with their wealth and money. Inna Allah hashtara min al mu'minin anfusahum wa amwalahum bi anna lahumul janna, because the lives and properties of the believers are only for the sake of Allah Almighty. So they should utilize all of their money and wealth for the cause of Islam. Thanks so much, sir. Thank you. बिस्मिल्लाहिर रहमान रहीम। रिस्पेक्टेड व्यूअर्स, लेडीज़ एंड जेंटलमैन, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। वेलकम टू द प्रोग्राम 114 डायलॉग्स विद कुरान। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सूरह अल फतह। फतह मीन्स टू ओपन द डोर ऑफ सक्सेस एंड विक्ट्री। दिस सूरह वाज रिवील्ड इन मदीना, दैट इज़ मदनी सूरह, and it comprises 4 rukus and 29 verses. In the opening line of this surah, it was clarified, inna fatahna laka fatahan mubeena, we have opened the door to victory, clear victory for the Muslims. This surah has great importance with reference to pact of Hudaybiyah, because it was a pact between the Muslims and the Quraysh and all the non-believers, and this pact of Hudaybiyah opened all the doors to spread of Islam, to prosperity of Islam, to victory of Islam, and to establishment of Islamic state and society. Among the main topics, first of all, this surah highlights this fact that the pact of Hudaybiyah, that was great source of success and victory for the Muslims, and the believers were also given certificate of pleasure of Allah Almighty. The verse لَقَدْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ is yubay'unaka tahta shajara. Allah Almighty became pleased with the faithful when they took their pledge with the messenger of Allah Almighty. Those were 1400 companions of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, 1400, and they decided to sacrifice their dear lives for the cause and sake of Islam and Allah Almighty under the tree. When there was a rumor of massacre of Hazrat Usman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, who was sent as the delegate and representative of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to make negotiation and discussion with the Quraysh. This surah has also highlighted the condition of Meccans. They were full of proud and arrogance, and they were not ready to listen to the discussion and talk and discourses of the Muslims. But when all the believers, they took their pledge, and the Quraysh, the Meccans were informed of this great position and decision and promise of all the followers of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to shed the last drop of their blood for the cause of Islam, they were baffled and they had to make compromise, and they sent Suhail bin Amr along with Hazrat Usman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and there was a pact of Hudaybiyah. According to that pact, it was decided that the Muslims and the Quraysh would never start any fight, any war for 10 years. There would be complete peace, harmony and solidarity. There were some conditions which were apparently against policy and mission of Islam, but inwardly these were in favor of Islam, because Allah Almighty clarified, inna fatahna laka fatahan mubeena. This was a happy news and forecasting for the Muslims that this pact of Hudaybiyah will bring prosperity, victory and success for the Muslims in the long run. So when there was complete peace, the people started to think about the message and teachings of Quran and Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they entered Islam in groups. They embraced Islam, Hazrat Khalid bin Walid and Amr bin al-As, they also embraced Islam during this time. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he sent a lot of letters to different rulers of neighboring countries and tribes, and during this time the Muslims also taught a lesson to the Jews. They were totally deprived of Khyber and some other states because they broke the pact of Medina. They did not honor different conditions and sections of the pact, and as a result they were taught a lesson for breaking that promise. So this surah has also highlighted that the restlessness of the believers and faithful. It is apparently good, clear, but they must put their strong faith on Messenger of Allah Almighty. وَمَا يَنْتَكُنِ الْحَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيُّ يُوحَىٰ. Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam does not say anything from his own intentions and from his own sweet will, but whatever is revealed to him, he only speaks the words of Allah Almighty. So all of his actions are under the guidance and patronage of Allah Almighty, so he cannot do anything wrong. This surah has also another topic, that the Muslims were allowed, they were given a chance to establish an Islamic state, a real Islamic society with all its pros and cons and different instructions and directions of Allah Almighty were also revealed in the Holy Quran to help the Muslims to establish a real welfare Islamic state and a welfare Muslim society. Above all, this surah gives the good news by Allah Almighty that ultimate victory and success will rest for the Muslims, and it came true. All the promises of Allah Almighty were fulfilled. Thanks to nice of you. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Respected viewers, Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the program 114 Dialogues with Quran. Today we are going to discuss Suratul Hujurat. This word has been derived from one of the verse of this surah. Innal-lazina yunadunaka mivral hujurat aksharuhum la yaqilun. The people who call for you outside the apartments, most of them are unwise, insane. This surah was revealed after migration of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca to Medina. It means it is Madani surah. It comprises only 2 rukus and 15 verses. Apparently it is very brief surah, but it is full of meanings, messages and complete Islamic society, all etiquettes, moral values. It highlights basic faith of Islam, good and moral full character of a faithful, and some basic etiquettes to attend the sweet company of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and some other social etiquettes and basis of Islamic ideology and Islamic nationality. The main topics of this surah, first of all, it has been highlighted that Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he enjoys a great status according to Allah Almighty, and all the Muslims are bound to pay rich tributes and homage to their dear Prophet, the Messenger of Allah, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they should be very much particular and careful while talking to him, while discussing different matters to him, and when he is at home, they should not call for him in an unwise or insane or irrational manner. Another main topic, that is about social etiquettes. The Muslims, the faithful, have been advised they must get authenticity of every news without making proper research and exploration. They should never put their faith and belief on the validity and authenticity of any news unless they get proper information and proper arguments and proof and validity of any news, because by this way so many troubles and disorder is created in society. Another topic that has been explained in this surah, that the companions of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it means Sahaba Ikram, they are also selected band of society, selected band of human beings, and Allah Almighty has endeared faith into the hearts of the companions of Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they must be given due regard, due respect, because they also enjoy respectable status according to Allah Almighty and the Holy Quran. This surah has also highlighted the basis of brotherhood according to Islam. As Allah Almighty says, Ya ayyuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabail li ta'arafu inna akramakum indallahi yataqakum. O all human beings, you have been created by Allah Almighty and you have been given birth by one man, Hazrat Adam, and one woman, Hazrat Hawa alayhimus salam, and you have been made families, tribes, so that you could get proper identification of one another, and the most honorable and respectable among all of you is that one who is the most righteous and pious according to Allah Almighty. Then this surah has also highlighted another fact, that every Muslim is advised to stay away from all bad morals. They must honor good moral values. They must stay away from backbiting, from jealousy, from enmity, from misunderstandings, doubts and suspicions. They should never give bad names to Muslims, to human beings, and they should present a very moderate and very honest and pleasing and amicable lifestyle, so that an Islamic society could be an ideal society and an Islamic state could be a welfare state. Furthermore, it has been also been pointed out that Islamic ideology and nationality, it is based upon faith, belief on Allah Almighty, on Hazrat Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's prophethood, on the Holy Quran. So the differences of color, creed, language and geographical boundaries, they are not given importance according to teachings of Islam. If a person embraces Islam, then he becomes the member of Islamic society. This surah has also described the holy war, the crusade. All the Muslims have been advised to play their due role for propagation of Islam. They should put all of their energies physically and all of their resources, their wealth and money, whatever they have been granted by Allah Almighty, they should be every time ready to sacrifice each and everything for the cause of Islam. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ La sharika lahu wa bizalika umirtu wa ana awwalul muslimin. The life and death and properties, prayers, sacrifices, hajj, each and everything must be dedicated and devoted for sake and recognition of Allah Almighty. Thanks so nice of you. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, respected viewers, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the program 114 Dialogues with Quran. Today we are going to discuss Surah Qaf. Qaf is separated alphabet. The first great interpreter of the Holy Quran, Hazrat Abdullah bin Abbas, he stated that Qaf, here it means one of the attributed names of Allah Almighty, which means Allah Almighty is supreme power and authority of this universe. He is the Lord and Creator, and Inna Allaha ala kulli shayin qadir. Surely Allah Almighty is the supreme authority over everything. This surah comprises three rukus and here are 45 verses. It was revealed in Mecca. The main topics of this surah, first of all, there is belief of life after death. Because it was very astonishing fact and news for the idolaters, the people of Quraysh, they were not ready to accept how a man can be given new birth, how the scattered pieces of body can be reunited. But Allah Almighty has given different arguments that this process of life or death is carried on with rain, with this barren land, with this greenery, the crops, the vegetables, the fruit, and so many flowers and plants. A man gets asleep just like the death, he wakes up just like a new life. So for the sane people, there are so many arguments and proof. Another topic is about the research of this vast universe, the astrology. Allah Almighty has pointed out in this surah that this vast universe has been created by Allah Almighty. It is so vast and great that a man cannot imagine. Even the astronauts and the astronomy, especially Lord James Jeans, he has pointed out that there are countless millions and billions of billions planets and stars, and so huge and greatly bigger than our small earth, and they are roaming about in the space violently. No one can imagine their speed and their big volume. So it is clear that there is a Lord, there is a Creator who is the omnipotent, who is the all-knowing, who is the supreme authority, who is the Lord, and who has managed and handled all these objects of universe of nature. Another topic that is about the warning to the rejectors. Allah Almighty has pointed out that the non-believers, they would meet their tragic end. They must take their senses. They should adopt rational attitude. Their way of thinking and doing all these actions, that is quite irrational. Another topic that is about the existence of Allah Almighty. Allah Almighty has clearly described that this vast universe is a great proof for the existence and omnipotency and final authority of Allah Almighty. Otherwise, this systematic universe will be collapsed. It is controlled by the great authority of Allah Almighty. And in the end, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has also been advised to be steadfast in his mission and to observe patience, because the non-believers and idolaters of ancient history, they had also been giving very tough and hard time to the prophets and messengers of Allah Almighty. So you should also be steadfast, and Allah Almighty will support you, and in the long run you will get victory and success. Thanks so much of you.